Not one, but two union ministers have distinguished themselves over the past few days. There is Jayant Sinha, who has, of course, an Harvard education, no less. He actually garlanded lynching convicts in Jharkhand and then made it worse with his explanation on Twitter. And then there was Union Minister Giriraj Singh, who went to visit riot accused in a Bihar jail. Bihar Chief Minister and BJP ally Nitish Kumar today criticized Singh for this. But the question is, why are both these men still ministers? We've heard the Prime Minister talk about Gaurakshaks in the past after long silences. He has warned against taking the law into one's own hands, and yet he is silent again on what his own ministers are doing. Now, is this because they don't care about what he says? That's highly unlikely. Or is it because he is choosing to look the other way? Well, 50 former civil servants, in fact, have issued a public statement today criticizing Jayant Sinha, saying that it was most unseemly of the union minister to felicitate such events as though some revolutionaries were there in a freedom struggle. His subsequent feeble justifications on social media do not hold water. They said, "We strongly condemn his action, which amounts to showing contempt for the rule of law." This is what 50 former civil servants have said in a public statement today. So the question is that, is there tacit support by the state for actions like these? What does the Prime Minister's silence tell us? Joining us tonight, Manish Tiwari from the Congress Party, Harsh Mandar, who has been travelling with a group of activists for some time now, wherever lynchings have taken place in this country, and has seen on the ground the kind of impact that's having. Shekhar Gupta of The Print joining us here in the studio, and Raghav Avasthi, lawyer and member of the RSS, joining us as well. Harsh Mandar, to you first, does it seem to you that this is now all sort of par for the course, that facilitating riot accused, lynching accused, convicts in the lynching case, in fact, is a new normal, that it's being normalized? Because apart from the outrage we saw over the weekend, you know, no one else is really talking about it anymore. So Jayant Sinha knows that he has nothing to worry about.
Absolutely. You know, I think that, you know, this is not the first case. We've seen, you know, when Afrasul was lynched in Rajasthan, the local minister and the local member of parliament were part of a WhatsApp group which called him Shere Mewar, the Shambhu who lynched him on, in front of a video camera. And this has happened over and over again. We have Mahesh Sharma, who rapped Akhlaq's accused killer in a flag. This is happening over and over again. And I would go so far as saying that I believe that the actions of, you know, the actions of the lynch mobs, the men who participate in lynching, they need to be punished. They've committed grave crimes. But what leaders like Jayant Sinha are doing is actually a much greater crime, much more culpable, because they are creating an environment which legitimizes hatred, which valorizes lynch mobs, lynch mob killers. And you know, the story, I went to Jharkhand, I met the family. Here's somebody who was a coal trader. He wasn't a meat trader, he was a coal trader, he was traveling. Suddenly this amount of meat appears out of the blue. They pull him out. They're BJP workers among the people who pull him out. They lynch him to death. They videotape it. His son actually receives the videotape while he's being lynched. It is just such a horrible crime. This is one of the rare cases where we had a very good police investigation, a very fair judge.
But
a much greater crime
is committed by people like Jayant Sinha, who then legitimize this hatred, as you put it, who valorize lynch mob killers. That's a very important point. Shekhar Gupta, I think a lot of people were also just taken by surprise that Jayant Sinha, IIT graduate, Harvard educated, someone like him could do something like this, and yet many others pointed out, why are you surprised?
Well, first of all, not being able to boast of any such fancy degrees from reputed places, let me say that to link somebody's a public figure's conduct with where they went to for education is very elitist. So let's keep that out of the equation.
Well, you expect better from people who've had a good education.
You expect
it's not
better.
About elitism.
No,
you expect them to have a better worldview.
Do you expect better from Mr. Modi, whose degree you don't know where it came from?
Well, certainly I do. He's the Prime Minister.
Yes. So when somebody becomes a minister or an MP, you expect good conduct from them, irrespective of their degrees. I think this thing of in spite of being, suppose he was illiterate, he would still not be expected to do this. It will be equally bad. So I'm getting distracted. It is greatly disappointing. If you want to take a very forgiving view, it's a great misjudgment. But really, that misjudgment could be corrected afterwards. These people are convicts. Their conviction has not been set aside. High Court has not declared them innocent. It is a terrible thing to be seen honoring convicts of murder, and murder also murder by lynching. Even if you think that injustice has been done to them, I'm sure some people think injustice has definitely
their
lawyer.
You wait for the law to take its definitely course, their as lawyer, you said you would.
Their lawyers think injustice has been done to them, but you have to wait. Because if a court has been kind enough to give them bail, expect that court to also give them justice. So save your celebrations for later. Don't do it now.
The question though, Manish Tiwari, is that and we've debated a lot about what Jayant Sinha and even what Giriraj Singh have done over the weekend. The question is, why are they still ministers? In any other civilized democracy, they would have been sacked by now for what they did. But they're there. And like I said, after the initial outrage, we've become so used to this, it's become so normalized that nobody is even saying, should Jayant Sinha resign? Should Giriraj Singh resign?
Nidhi, you are absolutely correct, because we've been saying for a while now that there is nothing called fringe. The fringe is the mainstream. And therefore, that's why you see ministers emboldened to indulge in such conduct. And it's really unfortunate, because you have a number of loose cannons in this government, and they have been swinging from the sublime to the ridiculous on a regular basis over the past 4 years. But you did expect something different from Mr. Jayant Sinha. It has nothing to do with his education, but he's a erudite, articulate, thinking person. And therefore, we would think that he would behave in a far, far more dignified manner. But I think it is what it is indicative of is a kind of desperation. The fact is that this government has no narrative left. The economy is up a creek without a paddle, internal security is in a mess, foreign policy, as Mr. Shekhar Gupta wrote, is possibly being thrown to the winds completely. So when they go into 2019, this government has no achievements to talk about. So except for falling back on polarization, beating down on the Kashmiris in order to accentuate the otherness of the other, there is nothing else which they have as a narrative to fight an election.
Okay.
And that's why you see even people who were the fringe earlier, or people who were considered sensible earlier, now succumbing to the temptation of polarization.
Well, there's no fringe. Like you said, the fringe is the mainstream. So, Raghav Avasthi, what's happening here? We have heard the Prime Minister in the past speak out about these things. He's in particular about Gaurakshaks, people taking the law into their own hands. Is it that these ministers don't care about what the Prime Minister says? Are they defying him?
Mr. Tiwari first. He's somebody whom I respect greatly. Having said that, it's a bit rich on the part of somebody who is a member of the Congress Party, which has had truck with the Popular Front of India in the past, which has also been known to chop off hands, if I remember correctly. So, let's not have the Congress Party sermonizing anybody. Now, coming to the point, I think it's great that these vigilantes have been punished on the watch of the BJP government in Jharkhand. And as Mr. Mander himself pointed out, the investigation was carried out in a fair manner and convictions have been done. As far as the issue of ministers going and felicitating these people who are, as a matter of fact, out on bail is concerned, the larger point that we have to figure out somewhere is this. India's Volksgeist as well as constitutional law is loaded towards the protection of cows and ensuring that cow slaughter does not take place. If the law does not take its own course and people get the impression that these cattle traders and beef smugglers will go away scot-free, then the public sympathy will automatically lie with the perpetrators rather than the victims. And this is also something that we have to appreciate, and all politicians at the end of the day have to somewhere, you know, mirror the opinions of their constituents.
I see. So if you admitted it's cynical politics that
Jayant Sinha. It's not cynical politics. I didn't say that.
Should
it is cynical
politics.
Should
he have done that? Should he have garlanded those people?
Do what? Garlanded those people? I mean, the point is just this. If the public sympathy, if the public feels that somehow the law is not taking its own course.
No, the and public somehow, can feel what it wants. The law is the law.
Yeah, the law
the
is
process
the law.
So of the law is the process
BJP
of the government, law.
The BJP government is
so
not
should
has
a
not
minister, should, yes
the
or no,
Jharkhand
should
BJP government,
Jayant Sinha have garlanded convicts, people who have been convicted of lynching, of murder?
Somewhere you also have to appreciate.
No, yes or no.
I will tell you why.
No, yes or no. Should
somewhere
he have garlanded
you also have
them?
To appreciate. Somewhere no.
Should he have
somewhere
garlanded
he
them?
Also, we also need to
yes
appreciate
or no? I need a
that
yes
the
or
good
no
people of that the good people of Jharkhand, their sympathies lie with the
no,
perpetrators
no, no.
in this
I'm
case.
I'm asking that as
and
a union minister, as a union minister, when a case is pending before the courts, when they have been convicted already by one court, should
they're
he have garlanded
them? They are out on bail, and the public
but
and the impression.
But their conviction is not overturned.
And the impression.
Impression is not anything. There is the law, and then there is impression.
So he is not interfering with the process of the law. He hasn't said that the Jharkhand High Court should not pass its judgment
what is
on
the
them.
He
is not trying
when
to interfere
he
at all.
Them. Yes, so
do,
you agree that
he
should
do
garland.
Whatever he wants.
Murder accused should be garlanded.
It's freedom of speech and expression under Article 19.
Okay, so tomorrow you tell me that somebody goes rape somebody. That's freedom of speech. Somebody goes and commits
to garland
a crime,
someone?
That's freedom
is
of expression.
Is it a crime to garland someone? Tell me this.
Garland murderers?
Is it a crime? Irrespective
really?
Of whether they are murderers.
A union minister, you are okay with a union minister
murderers.
Garlanding convicted murderers?
They are out on bail right now. He is not they interfering with the, he's not interfering.
He
as
is.
Long
the
as he's not
the moment he
garlands
them, he is interfering. And
how?
It is very
you're saying
scary
that the judges of the Jharkhand High Court will be influenced by union minister garlanding
face
someone?
And say that this is normal. It's
are you
not.
Saying? Are you saying that the judges of the Jharkhand High Court, and if the matter goes to the Supreme Court, then possibly the Supreme Court, those judges will be influenced by the factum of this person having garlanded someone?
Is he a union minister? Is
yes,
he not
he's a union minister.
And is he
as
not
long as
who
no, he's not. He's not
threatened.
He's not threatened the prosecution lawyers. The convictions have happened on the watch of the Jharkhand government and the prosecution. I mean, technically, it's the responsibility of the Jharkhand Home Ministry, and the Jharkhand government should be commended. But the
I'm
larger
sorry,
point is
I'm
this.
I'm
come in for
very,
a moment.
Very
do not, if we cannot ensure, if we cannot ensure that beef ban laws are enforced strictly throughout the country,
you are
then,
not answering the
I mean,
point.
Sympathy
the
of the public
laws,
will lie with the perpetrators rather
laws,
than the victims.
Cow slaughter laws
and
don't mean that anyone
Mr.
has a right
concerned,
to take a law into
I have one challenge for Mr. Tiwari.
You don't think he's emboldened people who are parts of lynch mobs that it's okay what you do?
No, but then if somebody is part of a lynch mob, if somebody is indulging in all of these vigilante actions, then as the government of Jharkhand has shown in this case, the full might of the law will be brought
them.
To bear
and then he goes
brought
and
to bear upon
them.
Them.
So he emboldens them.
But you have to also appreciate what the public is thinking.
I don't
appreciate
anyone
who garlands murderers.
What is
the public thinking
murderers.
At the end of the day?
I'm
the public
sorry, forgive me. Yes, Manish Tiwari.
Nidhi, it's extremely unfortunate and it's very regrettable that what you are hearing is justification for lynching. You know,
I didn't say
the
that.
Gentleman
Sir,
who's
Mr.
representing
Tiwari,
the
I didn't
says,
say that. I'm
please,
sorry.
Please, I heard you. I heard you. I heard you very
don't
carefully.
Me, sir.
Now have the patience to listen to me. No, I'm not misinterpreting you.
Yes,
I
you
heard
are.
You very carefully. And what you've said is a justification for lynching.
I have said that those who have lynched should be
punished. That's exactly what you're saying.
I'm
that's
saying that those
exactly
who lynch shall be
said.
Punished. That
you know,
you've
actually
you're
gone and
it,
justified lynching and saying and saying that,
no.
You know, because cattle traders or beef smugglers are not punished and therefore there's a popular upsurge against them. And if somebody goes and lynches them because action is not being taken,
sir,
you know, those who
I'm
then support
sorry,
it
are
actually
you are, a former IND minister.
Constituents. That's what
you are
said.
A former IND minister.
That's exactly what
I
said.
Don't think you've heard all
that's
of what
exactly
I said.
That's exactly what you
I said
and
very
let me tell you.
That those who have lynched have
I heard
been punished
it, I heard
first.
You very carefully.
Yes,
I heard you very
no,
carefully.
I said that those who
have
lynched should be punished
and
the Jharkhand government should be commended for it.
And actually
you are misinterpreting it, sir. It's unfortunate.
It is most
unfortunate.
And I think you should take it back.
No.
Because
you,
the subtext of what you're saying is justifying lynching. And I'll
your
tell you why a minister should not do it. The reason why a minister should not do it is because a minister, when he goes and garlands convicts, he's sending out a signal that the weight of the state actually is behind those people who are accused
exactly.
of crime.
That's exactly
what a minister is doing when he goes and garlands convicts. So therefore, whether it influences the High Court or doesn't influence the High Court or influence any judge or not, secondary, the message that you are sending is that the weight of the state, the weight of the union government,
sympathy of the public will lie with the perpetrators rather than the victims.
So what should we then read from the Prime Minister's eloquent silence on this? Because he'll come out once in a while, say that, oh, this is all very bad, and then he'll retreat into his shell and not say anything again. So clearly the signal that is going out to people saying this and doing this is that it's okay.
There is logic of politics. And then
there's
a demand of propriety and morality. See it a bit differently. Who came to that party with Trudeau that ruined his trip? It was somebody in Canada who was convicted for trying to kill an Indian politician, Sikh politician. He has served his sentence. Yet, because he came in to his party, traveling in India on a visa given by India, that it ruined the trip. So in public life, what you do publicly is very, very important, or view it differently. There's a bunch of people in jail still in Punjab, old terrorists, convicted. Any of them can be given bail. Some come out on parole every now and then. What will happen if one of the ministers there, forget a minister, if even somebody from SGPC garlanded them, or Kashmir,
hell would break loose.
Or Kashmir, any of the convicted terrorists could go home on parole for Eid, go home on parole for the funeral of a parent or a family member. What if Mehbooba or Umar garlanded them? You know, your competing channels will go to war and will not stop until Kashmir has been reconquered.
Which is why I'm saying it's sad that the outrage over this has just kind of, you know, dissipated, you know, except for the initial outrage, because this is something that any right-thinking person should say is wrong. It's just wrong. And Harsh Mandar, last question to you then. How does one fight back against that? If the dispensation clearly sees this as something that could politically help it, how does the common citizen fight back against that?
First, just dismantle the rationalizations. There was no popular anger resulting in a spate of lynch attacks based on the cow until this regime came to power. 97% of lynch attacks in the name of the cow after 2010 have happened after Mr. Modi came to power. So please let us recognize this is not a spontaneous popular anger. Even if it wasn't justified. But it is not a spontaneous popular anger. It is a manufactured anger for polarization. And we need to fight that back. Secondly, I do want to say something which will be unpopular. Every case of every case in which ministers and BJP leaders have valorized the killers, the victim has been Muslim. And I think that we need to say that very clearly, that there is a process of marking out the Muslim as the enemy within. Anyone who attacks them is a hero that needs to be valorized. It is the worst kind of politics. It's tearing apart India, and it's tearing apart the moral core of our people. And I think we need to call it for what it is, and we need to fight it loud and clear.
Well, one hopes that perhaps the Prime Minister, if he wants to, will say something on this as well. Thank you to all of you for joining us tonight.